Good morning, students. Happy to meet you all through this video lesson once again. What is your aim in life? Do you want to achieve something great? Do you have the courage and confidence to move forward towards your aim? The Bible says in Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So make God your partner, who will give you the strength, wisdom and courage from above, and plan big, as nothing is impossible with God. Let's move on to today's lesson, hydroxy derivatives and ethers.
Hello, Aisha.
Hello, friends.
Where are you going?
I'm going to revise the chemistry lesson before we attend today's class.
Yes, I'm also eagerly waiting for today's lesson. In the last class, we learnt about the preparation and some properties of phenol.
Yes, today let us see what we are going to learn.
Come, let's go to the class.
Today we are going to see the electrophilic substitutions of phenol. Before that, we'll understand why it undergoes. Phenol is a very good nucleophile. What is a nucleophile? Electron-rich species are called as nucleophiles. We know in phenol, just like a benzene ring, there are 6 pi electrons. Each double bond contains a pi electron, which is equally distributed among the 3 bonds. So that is why it can attract electrophiles, which are electron deficient. Now, what are the positions at which electrophilic substitution takes place in the benzene ring? We are going to draw the resonance structures. Now, in phenol, there is 2 lone pair of electrons in the oxygen which can change the position. So, when this electron comes in and forms a double bond, this double bond withdraws its pair of electrons and a negative charge is created here. Like that, as the charges move on, we can see the negative charges are created on the ortho position and the para position. So, this is a para ortho position. Now, when this bond electrons come here and form a bond, this bond will come out with its electrons and a negative charge will be created in the ortho position. And it goes on. So, finally, we can see that the negative charge is created in the ortho positions and the para positions. So, these are the positions which will be easily attacked by the electrophile. So, the first reaction is nitrosation. So, phenol, when it reacts with nitrous acid at low temperatures, it undergoes a reaction called as nitrosation, where the nitroso group is introduced. What is a nitroso group? So, this is phenol. I am taking nitrous acid. The ortho para position, the nitroso group is introduced. So, NO is called as a nitroso group and the compound is para nitroso phenol. What is para? When both the positions are exactly opposite to each other, then it is called as a para position or the para isomer. Next, let us see nitration. Here, phenol is treated with 20% nitric acid, where the ortho and the para isomers are formed. So, phenol on treatment dilute nitric acid, which is 20% nitric acid, we get ortho nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. You can see ortho, both the substituents are adjacent to each other in the 1 and 2 position. That is called as ortho isomer. Look at the para isomer, both of them are opposite to each other. This is called as 1,4 or para isomer. Now what happens when I take concentrated nitric acid along with concentrated sulfuric acid? Now this mixture is called as nitration mixture. You need to remember this, children. A mixture of concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid is called as nitration mixture. Drastic reaction takes place and we get what is picric acid. So phenol, 3 molecules of nitric acid, this is how it reacts. So we get what? And every position there is a hydrogen. That hydrogen reacts with OH and is removed as water. And we get what? Nitro. So what do we get? 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. This is like an explosive. So this compound is generally called as picric acid. 2,4,6 trinitrophenol is called as picric acid. They won't ask you how does phenol react with nitration mixture. They will ask you how is picric acid formed. Or how is 2,4,6 trinitrophenol formed from phenol. Anyway, they can ask and you have to write the equation. Next, we are going to see sulfonation. Sulfonic acid group will be introduced. In all these cases, NO2 is the positive electrophile here. So now phenol is treated with concentrated sulfuric acid when a mixture of both ortho and para phenol sulfonic acid is formed. Now you may be wondering, what is electrophile here? Now we know sulfuric acid will ionize. In this case, it will ionize like this: SO3H+ and OH-. So this is the electrophile which is introduced in the ortho position and the para position. Remember, everywhere there is one hydrogen. That H and OH will be removed as what? Water. And this sulfonic acid, SO3H, is called as the sulfonic acid group. And the sulfonic acid group is introduced in the ortho position and the para position. So as I have been telling you, when they are opposite each other, they are called as what? Para isomer. Adjacent to each other, they are called as ortho isomer. Next, let us see halogenation. We know halogens. Fluorine, bromine, chlorine, and iodine are called as halogens belonging to the 7th group. Now, first, phenol, when it is treated with bromine water, which is a reddish brown liquid, all the three positions, the ortho and the para positions, are replaced by the bromine, forming 2,4,6 tribromophenol. This is a white precipitate. This can be even taken as a test for phenol. So immediately when phenol reacts with bromine water, we get a white precipitate of 2,4,6 tribromophenol. As I told you, immediately both the ortho positions and the para position, simultaneously they are substituted by the bromine atom. Just like picric acid, 2,4,6 trinitro, and this is 2,4,6 tribromophenol. Phenol undergoes bromination in the presence of carbon disulfide or carbon tetrachloride just to form the orthoisomer or the paraisomer. All the three places are not substituted. See, phenol reacts with bromine in the presence of carbon disulfide. Only the ortho position or the para position is substituted. So this is called as orthobromophenol or 2-bromophenol, and this is called as parabromophenol or 4-bromophenol. This is a major product. Now we are going to see some important name reactions of phenol, which is called as Kolb's reaction, the first one. Now sodium phenoxide, not phenol but sodium phenoxide, reacts with carbon dioxide at 400 Kelvin at 4 atmospheres to give salicylic acid. The moment when we say Kolb's reaction, you should connect it with sodium phenoxide, carbon dioxide, 400 Kelvin. So let's see the reaction. So in the first step, phenol is reacted with sodium hydroxide. The hydrogen is replaced by sodium to give sodium phenoxide. This sodium phenoxide reacts with carbon dioxide at 400 Kelvin to give an intermediate product called a sodium salicylate. This sodium salicylate, on hydrolysis in the presence of HCl, Na is removed as NaCl and H comes here, and we get what is called as salicylic acid. This salicylic acid is quite important as it is used in the preparation of aspirin, paracetamol and all. Next, we are going to see Riemer-Thiemann reaction. Here, phenol reacts with chloroform in the presence of sodium hydroxide to give what is called a salicylaldehyde. Instead of carboxylic acid, we get an aldehyde group over here. See, phenol reacts with chloroform. CHCl3 is chloroform. Sodium hydroxide and 343 Kelvin gives an addition compound, intermediate compound, which on further hydrolysis gives salicylaldehyde. So this is the major product. The next reaction, phenolphthalein. We know we use phenolphthalein as an indicator in the lab, acid-base indicator. This phenolphthalein is an organic compound. It is also prepared by the action of phenol. See, this phenolphthalein is colorless in the acid medium but gives a pink color in the basic medium. Let's see how to prepare it. The reaction is called as thallene fusion reaction. Phenol reacts with a compound called as phthalic anhydride. It is an anhydride. We have two COOH groups. When they condense and remove water, we get anhydride without water. So this phthalic anhydride and two molecules of phenol condense in the presence of sulfuric acid to form phenolphthalein. We know concentrated sulfuric acid is a dehydrating agent. So this is phenolphthalein, the indicator which we use. The next reaction is called as coupling reaction. The reaction is also called as diacetization. Here, phenol reacts with benzene diazonium chloride benzene diazonium chloride C6H5N2Cl. Again, in the presence of sodium hydroxide to give para hydroxyazobenzene. This is a red color dye which is used for dyeing and coloring clothes, fibers, everything. Let's look at the reaction. This is benzene diazonium chloride C6H5N2. There is a double bond between N2. This group is called as the azo group. This is phenol. We know hydrogen is there in every carbon. HCl is removed. Only HCl is removed. Rest, just write the rest. So what do we get? C6H5N double bond N C6H5OH. Para hydroxy azo benzene. This is how you have to remember the name. This is in the para position. N double bond N is called as the azo group. Para hydroxy azo benzene. This is a red dye. Which is a beautiful, nice color it will get. You will get. The next, we are going to see some tests to differentiate alcohol and phenol. First one, when we take benzene diazonium chloride and react it, only phenol will give the red test, just now we saw. But alcohol will not give the dye test. Only phenol will answer the dye test. Next, neutral ferric chloride. When we add neutral ferric chloride, phenol gives a purple color or violet color immediately. This is just a good test for phenol and often repeated objective question. But alcohols, aliphatic alcohols, do not give any color. Then with sodium hydroxide, only phenol forms sodium phenoxide. Alcohols do not form sodium phenoxide with sodium hydroxide. That is why these three tests can be taken to distinguish alcohol and phenol. Finally, we are going to see the uses of phenol. Phenol is used for making Bakelite. You know, the plastic cooker handles everything. Bakelite is called as a material of 1000 uses. All your plastics, cooker handles, non-stick materials, your telephone, your plastics, many articles are made up of plastic nowadays. And it is a condensation polymer of formaldehyde and phenol. This is phenol. CH2O is phenol, formaldehyde. Everywhere one hydrogen from here and one oxygen from the formaldehyde is removed as water. And we get a condensation polymer of Bakelite. As I said, your cooker handles, everything is made up of Bakelite. It is also used in the making of drugs like phenacetin. Phenacetin has got, it is a painkiller. It is found in Vicks, Iodex, your Olitra, Olini, everything. Any pain killing medicines will have phenacetin combination. Aspirin, paracetamol, brufen, everything contains phenacetin. And in the preparation of salol, it can be used as a disinfectant too. And we just now, we already saw, it is used in the preparation of phenolphthalein, which is an indicator. And previous reaction we learnt, picric acid, which is an explosive. What is picric acid? 2,4,6-trinitrophenol is picric acid, which is an explosive. And it is also widely used in the making of phenyl. You know phenyl, which is a disinfectant. This phenol is antibacterial, antiviral and antifungal. A dilute solution can be used for disinfecting floors and tiles. And also in the preparation of soap, which is good for the skin, it because of its germicidal properties. So today in this class, children, we learnt about the electrophilic substitution of phenol, a test to differentiate alcohol and phenol, and the uses of phenol. Go through the lesson in the text, go through the video, then take up the test and the Kahoot. Please write and see the equations. Do not waste time. Take care, children. Thank you.